Now I'm going to talk about the game engine tweaks, changes, and options that you may have in the game. The first thing I want to talk about is that the ground games from DOA 2 and DOA 4 are in the game. So now the grounded hits that you used to be able to do back then, like Jan Li's down kick or Hayabusa's down punch, are now back in the game. You also have DOA 4's ground game, which is the force tech. You know, if they lay on the floor for too long, you can use a move, they will tech them up, or use two weak moves to get them up, and you know, you'll have the option to do uncounterable attacks or whatever. You don't get both options though. You only get one or the other. So it kind of depends what attack you do. I've noticed if you just don't use the move that would do the ground hit animation, you'll get the force tech instead. However, it's kind of hard to do because sometimes you want that specific move and you won't get it. So it's kind of iffy. Sometimes you get the ground hit from DOA 2 and sometimes you get a DOA 4 ground hit. I'm not sure what exactly separates them or how they fall. I've noticed that if they fall certain ways, you'll get this one. If they fall a different way, you'll get the other. You do have the option to pick English voices or Japanese voices. So if English is just not your cup of tea, pick the Japanese and vice versa. The command list is completely taken out of the game because of the touch panel below. The command list is almost always shown throughout the whole game, and you can also lock it to avoid touching it by accident. I didn't get to experiment too much with it, but there is a lock key in there. So if you don't want to touch it and you happen just to be mashing too many buttons and you accidentally touch the screen, you can avoid that completely. However, you won't have the option to pause the game and look at the command list since it's always shown there in real time throughout all of the game, even training mode. Combo throws can be done in the touch panel below, which means it will do the whole combo throw animation. However, if they're breakable throws and you time them correctly, you should still be able to break them. Tag mode is now tag challenge. It really has two characters versus one strong character. It's not your traditional tag team mode, which I'm sure a lot of us would have rather preferred, but it's just a tag challenge mode. We didn't get to get a whole lot of testing on that, so all I know is it's two characters versus one strong character. DOA Dimensions Online Lobbies will be very similar to DOA Ultimate's Online Lobbies. Right now, we're not sure if you'll have a spectator mode, but at least the lobby system will look very similar. The hold damage in DOA Dimensions is similar to DOA 4's hold damage. If you're not stunned and you hold them, you'll take more life than normal. If you are stunned, the damage is reduced. The air combo revision has been tweaked, it seems. Some combos now do more damage. I guess it kind of depends on which combos you do, but you might want to check out each combo from your character as soon as you get the game, because some of the combos I'm used to doing take more damage now than they did before. As I mentioned before, untechables are still in the game. Some still have different setups though. They have changed just a little bit, but since you have the untechables, they can still lead to uncounterables and you still can't counter in certain key situations. Some of the stages that are in there and that we played on just seem better. They seem bigger than before. There's not always a wall right behind you all the time. So the stages that you guys will get to play on, I'm sure you guys are gonna like. A lot of space, but at the same time, there's still a lot of stuff in the way that it can get you in trouble. When you get knocked into a wall, you'll still have the option to hold and slow escape. Slow escaping in this game seems like it's been toned down. I'm not sure if it's because of the D-pad, but we did mash it and it's not as easy. It seems more close to DOA 2, maybe DOA 3 style, nowhere near DOA 4 style. When you're on the floor, you're still granted the low, mid, and high get-up kicks. That was not changed. We're not sure about the invincibility frames, but as far as we know, it's about the same. Like I mentioned earlier, there's no more crumple stuns. There's no more stuns that will cause you to hold your stomach and make you fall all the way to the floor very slowly. The other stuns that were taken out of the game are the heavy sit-down stuns, like Hayabusa's 4-4 punch, that will cause you to push back, fall down, and would force you to stay in the stun for a little while before you can hold. The only sit-down stuns that are still in the game are, you know, your common down forward kick stuns, down kick stuns, and your down back punch stuns. The reason I say common is because the majority of most characters will cause you to sit down with those inputs. However, of course, you have to check your character's moveset to see what actually sits you down. So like I said, down forward kicks that kind of sit you down kicks that make you trip down, and down back punches like Tina's down back punch that will make you sit down are the only ones that are still in the game, and they still cause you to wait just slightly before you can hold. The lighting effects and slowdown effects cannot be changed in the game. They really don't bother the player, it's only a matter of just getting used to it. Critical time is now in the game, as you can see in some of the trailers. I believe the main purpose of that is just to notify both players that someone is in the defensive, and it wasn't obvious enough, I guess, in the animation that they were out of stun or in stun. So when they're out of stun, the critical time will disappear and it'll notify both players that, hey, you're not stunned anymore, and it can block. The stun threshold is now shown in real time throughout the whole game. Previous DOA games did that. Now we're kind of back to that. So whenever you stun somebody, it'll show on the life bar like a darker life bar next to it, showing you how far you can pretty much take the stun and then before they fall down. Some crushes in the game, like Hayabusa's down plus K, Helena's P plus K, seem to have lost some of their evasiveness. They still are evasive, but they don't seem like they have the same amount of evasive frames. So that seems to have changed. We'll have to do more testing when the game comes out, obviously, but it just doesn't seem as evasive. The offensive holds, or the castros, however you want to call them, are still in the game. Every character still has them. It seems like they might have added a few extra active frames. Right now they're at 3. They could be at 4 now. They just seem more effective. That's pretty much it for the most part. Some of the things that got discussed in the forums that were not supposed to be discussed, but I'll mention because it did get posted in some of the public forums, is that high level jumping is no longer in the game. That's something that wasn't supposed to be discussed, but since it's already out there, high level jump is not going to happen to any character ever, unless it's just a specific command for that particular character. In this case, like I mentioned earlier, Kasumi happens to be that one character that can jump still, but it won't happen just by pushing up forward. It would have to be up forward and a punch or kick command. Not all characters have that, but Kasumi happens to be one of them that has it. High level jumps will be completely avoided in this game. Another thing that kind of slipped out was that jabs caused a stun on counter hit. Before in DOA 2, 3, and 4, if you jab somebody and got a counter hit, you usually got advantage. Rather be plus 1, 2, or 3, just kind of depend on your character. Now it gives you a short stun. It gives you like plus 10 to plus 13 frames. It really kind of depends on your character. It's a short stun, it doesn't last very long. And if they're in stun and you jab them to extend it to that really long stun, not gonna happen. It's gonna be that short stun again. So jabs will not be used to extend stuns for that really long stun that lasts long enough for you to do whatever it is you want to do. So there you go. You got some of the stuff that we got to play that we could talk about, pretty much everything we could talk about, and a few things we weren't supposed to talk about and just kind of slipped out. We're going to try to see if we can release more information. Sometimes it's only a matter of waiting for Game Trailers because Game Trailers has exclusivity on releasing information. So it's only a matter of waiting for them sometimes, and after that we can expand on it. But if we can get some more information out, we're definitely going to bring it out and try to give it to you. For now, I hope you guys got enough information, things that you can kind of think about to see what you can change in the game. There's still a lot of other information that unfortunately we just can't talk about, but the other information I can't talk about, I'll tell you right now, is pretty big stuff. I mean, it'll change the game, how it's played completely. Until then, just stay tuned to see what other videos or content that we put out. If you have any questions or comments, just post them on this video. I'll have this sent to DOA Central, so it'll probably be sent to the DOA Central YouTube channel. So just post there, and there'll probably be a thread made for the video so you can post what you think, what you would probably change, things of that nature. So again, thanks for tuning in. Didn't make it any special, just kind of bringing you the information. So I'll catch you guys next time.